So welcome back to our channel. Today we are going to be discussing the myths and the wonders and the big conversational topic of E10 fuel. Yes, E10 fuel has graced the presence of us here in the UK. Is it any good? Can you use it in small machinery? Well, we're going to do a very special experiment to find out whether you can use it in your STIHL equipment.
So we're going to do E10 versus STIHL MotoMix. So we're going to fill both machines up with the fuel, we're going to run them, and then we're going to store them, and we're going to see what happens to these stores in
6 months.
6 months, yeah.
6 months, then see if they start again and see how they perform. So today we're going to fill them up, do some cutting with them, see how well they go through the wood, and then we're going to do the same thing in 6 months' time. So make sure you subscribe to our channel so you don't miss out on that video. One sort is going to have E10 mix with 50 to 1, and the other one is going to have the STIHL MotoMix.
Well, first of all, tell me, why is our saws different?
They are different, okay. We've got two MS231s, nice saws, very nice saws.
They're on our website, haysmachinery.co.uk.
They are available on our website. This is the C, and you've got the...
Just the standard?
Standard.
Yeah.
So the difference
is... just a 231.
This one has a special recoil in it so that you can... it's an easier to start saw, but not easier with regards to fresh fuel. That's normally the problem why people can't start machinery. This one's got the easy start, so you just pull it up and sort of it automatically starts itself. That one has got the standard recoil on, which everyone's used to.
So James, can you use E10 fuel in a STIHL chainsaw?
Yes, and I'll tell you why. So E10 fuel is absolutely fine to run in your STIHL chainsaws, power equipment, two strokes, whatever it is you've got a STIHL, E10 is absolutely fine. In actual fact, STIHL have been developing their products for 18 years to be able to run on E10 fuel. Yeah, 18 years. They've been doing this for a long time, but there is a negative, isn't there, Ryan?
It is. The negative is down to the storage of E10. So E10 means it's up to 10% ethanol. And what ethanol does, it attracts water vapor. So it's been stored for quite a long time. The water vapor in the air attaches to the ethanol content in the fuel, leading to fuel segregation. No one wants water in their fuel. That then can actually rust out your carb on the inside. I don't know if you've seen other videos, old mowers and things like that, with white inside the carburetors and things like that. That's what happens to these ones here. That is the ethanol content in there with the water mixing up and actually rusting from inside. So fresh E10 fuel, no problems at all, but after around about 30 days, and even STIHL's guidelines says anything over 30 days E10 fuel, it's best to disregard the fuel in a safe manner.
So if you're a professional, that's going to be absolutely fine. You can run your saw on E10 fuel all day long, all day, every day, which is great. But let's say you were a domestic user and you only use your saw for a few days a year, but you store it with E10 fuel in it, you're going to come to a point where you're going to get that saw off the shelf and that fuel's going to be stale inside. It's going to have all dried up. It's going to, all your gaskets and diaphragms and everything that's inside your carburetor are not going to be very good, and it's probably not going to work very well. But there is another option, Ryan, and that option is
alkali petrol. So this one here is STIHL MotoMix, for example, and it is a E0 fuel. James, can you tell me more about it?
There is no ethanol in STIHL MotoMix. It is an alkylate fuel. It lasts for up to 5 years. So even if it's in your little priming bulb on your machine, this little gizmo here, even if it's in there, it'll still last for 5 years. It's got those beautiful properties about it. But another massive thing is for your health. It's a lot safer. It's a lot easier to use. It doesn't have all of the horrible, was it benzenes and enzymes and
Denzenes.
Yeah, loads of zines. There's lots of zines in that. We don't like zines. But yeah, that's got lots of horrible things in it which aren't very good. Whereas the alkylate fuel is such a refined process, how they make it. It is a really, really clean fuel. We've been using alkylate fuel for 7 years.
7 years.
7 years in our workshops. Because we know that if we service a machine and then the customer takes it away, but they don't use it for 6 months, we know it's still going to work. So there's also another interesting thing about STIHL chainsaws and their development.
See, on the standard tunable carburetors, yep, recommended no more than E10 fuel on there. It just won't handle it. However, if you've got an M-tronic saw, mainly designed for the professional users, those saws have actually been engineered and designed for up to E25 fuel. So they're trying to future-proof those saws going forward. That's very unique to STIHL. Not aware of any other manufacturers doing that.
Yeah, so E25% ethanol content. If you run an M-tronic carb in your professional equipment,
it's gonna be like...
I must be like, yeah, it must be, because I don't think they make an E25 fuel. They probably do somewhere in some laboratory in China. Anyway, we all know what happens there. It must just be full of water. Because as Ryan said, the ethanol just draws water towards it. Water is attracted to it.
So well, if E10, E10, you're not recommended to store it for more than 30 days, yeah. E25 must be what, a few hours?
Three.
It's dreadful.
Right, so why Ryan has gone to put his glad rags on, because he's going to do the cutting. It's only fair. I think you've seen me do enough cutting in the time, and you're taking a mick out of me anyway, and I'm doing it, so you might as well take a mick out of Ryan instead. Please do in the comments, by the way. Comment on all of his cutting techniques, because that's just fun. We are going to go for the E10 in the MS231C in here, so all premixed. It is exactly 50 to 1 to manufacturer's recommendations. I'm going to fill it right up. There we go. She's full. By the way, we did have all the carbs cleaned, both carbs cleaned on these saws, because they are secondhand saws. We thought, well, you're not storing new saws all the time, because once you've used them, they're secondhand. So we thought we'd use two saws which have been pre-used. Clip your cap on that one. That's now sealed, not coming off for 6 months. Let's put the MotoMix into the normal MS231. It's not like we've never made any mistakes in our videos before. I know, look at that, look, it pours really, really well. Oh, look at that, MotoMix filled right to the top. Two saws filled up with the correct jungle juice to the manufacturer specifications, all ready for Ryan to do some cutting. Let's go and find out where he's due and get him to cut through a log. So I got my main man Ryan here dressed in his STIHL PPE. Well, nearly all STIHL PPE. We apologise for any offence caused.
If STIHL Marketing's watching this, I could really do with another pair of trousers.
I know, look at it. Cheers. They almost look like they've been used. Step Ryan, which saw would you like first?
MS231, please.
MS231. All right, cheers for that. Well, that's that one, because that's a C. Ethanol or non-ethanol?
There let's we go. Let's go for ethanol first.
Ethanol first, which we have put into the C. I'm going to count how many times it takes to pull start it. It's not a time test. It's just literally to see what the power is like. So we're comparing this saw against what this saw is going to do in 6 months.
I'm ready.
I've got ear protection on, but I'm stood over here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Hey.
Oh, off with the choke. 6 so far, 7, 8. Right, 8 pulls.
8 pulls.
For the E10 fuel.
Oh, wait, here's the second hand saw.
Going through his log. Oh yes he is. He loves going through a log. But having a log, I suppose. Well then, Ryan, which saw would you like next, mate?
I'll have the other one.
That one?
Oh, yeah.
That makes a lot of sense, doesn't it? Stand by your timber! Hey, that's a bit like STIHL Timber Sports, isn't it? Don't forget, we've got a competition in a minute for our next subscriber giveaway. Oh, hang on, did I count them? Were you counting them? That's right, we'll go 6, 7, 8. Oh, 9. Right, 9 on the MotoMix at the moment.
But it is cold today as well.
Hey?
It is cold.
It is cold. It is cold. Suppose you could have sharpened the chains before we came out of today, but never mind, that's not what we're looking at. We're not looking at how quickly you can go through. We are looking at how well that will start and work compared to what it will in 6 months' time.
So now the fuel's gone all the way around the carb now, it's all gone into the cylinder, so we know it's coated the engine really well.
Yeah.
So good fair test for both saws.
Yeah, so both saws are now just going to be stopped and left for 6 months. What a waste of a saw, and no doubt someone's going to write that in the comments. Do you agree? Poor little chainsaws, they should be used, Ryan, shouldn't they?
They should be.
They should be put to work. Should we give something away for our next subscriber giveaway?
What do we need to do to enter?
Be a subscriber.
Is that it?
Yeah, as long as you subscribe to our channel, you are in with a chance of winning, no matter where you are in the world. How about that?
So who is the luckiest person this time?
So being that this is a STIHL video with STIHL chainsaws and STIHL MotoMix and a STIHL helmet,
STIHL trousers.
And STIHL trousers. I'm not calling Ryan a helmet, I promise.
And we're still here.
We're going to give away some STIHL goodies. Yes, we've got a lovely STIHL baseball cap, because we love a STIHL baseball cap. Who doesn't? And a STIHL limited edition Timber Sports bar. Beautiful looking bar. It is for 14 inch chainsaw bar running on a 3/8 chain. So there we are. And some key rings to add up. And if we find some more things, we might throw them in as well, including a sticker, a Haze Machinery sticker sheet.
Yeah, why not?
Because everyone's asking for them these days. Who is the winner today, Ryan? It is...
Electrical Ron.
Electrical Ron.
Congratulations.
Congratulations, Electrical Ron. Well done. You are the winner of some lovely prizes. Let us know in the comments or ping us an email, info@hazemachinery.co.uk, and we can get them sent off to you. We've got three things that our beautiful viewers need to know about this video. One is that yes, you can use E10 fuel in all of your STIHL equipment. Even STIHL say you can, so it's absolutely fine. The thing you mustn't do though
is don't store it for any longer than 30 days
because it's going to go off, it's going to go stale, it's going to do harm to your machines, it's not going to be a very nice experience at all. But even better still,
use STIHL MotoMix.
STIHL, better STIHL. Use STIHL MotoMix. It's got a 5-year shelf life. It's better for your health. It's
ethanol free
and it's pre-mixed. So you just literally have your saw, like you saw me do just now, you just tip it in and that's it. It's easy, nice and easy. So the interesting thing is, right, we'd like you to put in the comments, which one of those saws in 6 months' time do you think is going to start the quickest? Obviously it's 8 pulls on the E10 and it is 9 pulls on the MotoMix. That's probably something to do with the starter, but it's what we're comparing and what it's going to be like in 6 months' time. Which one do you think will start easier than the other? That'll be an interesting find out. I'm excited. We'll roll forward 6 months now.
But any other videos you want to see as well, just drop us a comment below. We'll get back to you and we'll see what we can do for you.
Definitely. We're Hayes Machinery.
This is our YouTube channel.
Please consider subscribing.
Thank you.
Thank you for watching.